It's a very complicated shape. Alright, we got the key card. That will let us in here. Well, who are you? How'd you get in my office? Anyway, I think you should leave now. I'm already infected. Even tried medication myself, but it doesn't slow the change. Or you can end my torment, give me a quick death. I guess.
Joe, it's funny, because of the delay in the stream, I thought you made that second sentence up.
I would only see heal a couple times. Gold key. Wait, did he drop the key when I killed him? Maybe that's needed for the... I think if we go back downstairs, there's the generator. This way.
This build's great, though. The detail in here.
Yeah. It's kind of, it reminds me of that mall, but it's more like intricate. Not quite as expansive, but more like specific little details. All right, we turn the power on. Now we can take the lift.
I like the wall texture, the block texture of the bricks.
It's very pleasant. Ooh. Whoa! Dwayne? You're not Dwayne. Oh, he hits hard. I didn't roll in time. Okay. I actually had to like think really hard about timing those rolls. Are you Rick? My dad said on the phone that you'd be coming. We should get out of here quickly. Did we just put him in our pocket? At least it's not an escort quest. Oh, hello.
It was amusing having the child do backflips every time I picked it up, though.
It was when we picked him up, yeah. Wait, were we in here before? I don't remember this room. Oh, this is where we got the keycard. There's so many! Yeah, do it now. Smash the like button.
If he survives, you have to.
Yeah. If I don't die in this part, and I beat the quest in time, you are legally obligated to like it. Not really. There's no obligations here. I also want to get all the zombies. We must clear... Oh boy. Did I say we had to survive?
Yeah.
And beat everything? Oh, these vampire dogs are tough though. We need to at least survive. Right out of here.
You got this.
They can't chase me in here. I can still hit them. Oh, we beat the timer. That's good. We just had to get out the door. They're still there. We can still attack them. We're good. All right, now you got to like. the backside detail of those vampire dogs, though, is something.
This is the downside of knowing how the games are built, though, is
knowing... you can do this. Yeah. Yeah, I know that AI can't do pathfinding past doors that used to be closed. Oh well. But it's also less fun that way. Oh, I'm getting surrounded though. Make it.
You only got 53 health left.
Shh, don't tell me the odds.
Oh, it's just drastically low.
It switched to 25 right before you said that. You do it. We got this.
So throughout that whole hospital scene that you went through, there was no respawn. What's the... You didn't teleport?
Well, I never died, so I don't know.
No, I mean, like, none of the doors...
Oh, no, I died!
Everything's actually built inside that building, you can see.
Oh, yeah, no, it's a fully laid out building. There haven't been any teleports in this. Ooh. These are corgis. Yeah, they look like corgis, but they're vampire dogs. They're like corgis with wolf heads. Oh.
Bone Dragon Cosmic Rug has been an experience on the Alpha.
Bone is Dragon what?
The Bone Dragon. Which experience is it in? It's in the Scientist, the Oracle's Hub.
It's in the Oracle's Hub, yeah.
Yeah.
What about it?
Someone's asking, can't find the video, but the dragon isn't all too big. Not sure how large the bone dragon is, to be honest.
Oh, yeah, we can, I own that. I can pull it up in the Game Maker.
You have the dragon.
I have two of them. At least one of them is supposed to go to the sandbox, because the sandbox has to buy the assets from the artists in order to put them in the game. It's part of like their contract and stuff. So, I heard an alert. I heard the danger noise.
Someone asked how large the Alpha Dragon is. I'm guessing it's based off the Dragon Template.
Yeah, I would think so. I can pull up the dimensions though. Oh, hello. Can run up there. Oh, we might still have a bunch more to do if we haven't even gone to the police station yet. I'm not sure. Let's get Dwayne home. Thank you so much for bringing Dwayne back. There is no word that can express the level of my gratitude. It's okay. Not really. That was hell. And we just got shotgun with a bayonet. I hear there's a refugee camp in Atlanta where everyone is headed. Your wife and son could be there. I could provide you food for the journey. I'll stick this gun. I found it in the police station before it was ruined. Safe journey. All right. So the Alpha Dragon, oh, that's cool. Just seeing the shadows pass over the door. It's because there's like a bird up in the sky, I think, or something.
Oh yeah, that's cool.
Yeah. It's interesting.
Desert setting. I don't see it used enough. I think, it's one of like the least used ambiance settings, but it's like very unique, you know?
Yeah, well, I think
especially for like the apocalypse-y stuff.
Yeah, for a lot of it, it's too yellow for a lot of settings, but when used right, it is like a nice like sunset effect almost. Okay, I guess we don't go in the police station because we just got the weapon.
You're not allowed to jump around anymore, anyway.
Shh.
You just have to walk. Shh.
5 a.m. Go to bed. I'm not that funny. No gas. Okay. Oh, I guess we can progress into the woods now. How long is this game? Like, I'm looking at the buildings in the distance. I'm like, we've only covered a quarter of this map.
We have done that four times, though.
Hmm. I don't know if that guy's health is higher, but it feels like the gun with bayonet doesn't do as much damage. Double check the stats. Oh, you know, I think these platforms here, these are probably the respawn points.
Oh, yeah.
Because I saw them in other spots. All right. Oh, yeah. This sword does way more damage. But it was, like, hidden. It was behind that curtain, so, like, you don't necessarily know that it's there. This sword does way more damage. Okay, maybe this is all just... This is actually really pretty. This is a great shot here. Do we ride the horse? Injured man.
Mist is at the perfect point as well.
Yeah. Yeah, where the city's just, like, obscured. People in the caves need help. Safe zone. Anything in here? Nothing? Oh, okay. There's a lot of space out here that's empty, though. So this, I would close this off so you can't run back here. Like, how there's just a stop sign way back there. I would block this off with more terrain walls. Don't tell me what to do. Yeah.
I see a few things.
Oh, in the gallery interesting. So from. Sorry, Andy, I couldn't really hear you.
No, go on, dude.
So the clouds that are like bright and glowing here, when we're this far back, we can't see their glow. You can actually kind of see the shape of them, which is kind of cool. But I wonder if they're moving a little bit, and that's what was actually. Yeah, they're very slowly moving side to side. I can see like a difference between the edges of them as they shift. So that was what was causing that shadow to change when we were inside the building. That's actually really cool. I know it's not as fancy as like full ray tracing and stuff, but I'm just so happy with how nice our shadows look in the game that you can get that effect of feeling like a bird fly overhead, things like that.
Yeah, I made a window and had like this the sunrise setting with the window coming into the side, and it actually looks like it's morning inside of a house. It really looks like really cool when it hits like a table and a coffee mug or something. It's like really well done.
It said warning, there's no way back. And I'm like, but that's Atlanta. That's where we're supposed to go. So what do you mean no way back? I want to know now. Is there a Sunday stream? There is not a Sunday stream. At least not from me. A little claustrophobic in here. Ow! Okay, that's electricity. How'd you get here? It's complicated, but there's no way back now. Our subway derailed and we had a lot of casualties. Moreover, some passengers went crazy and started attacking and biting others. Maybe we end up in Atlanta taking the subway. I was gonna leave the city before the virus spread. He knew something ahead of time. I saw a giant monster before we crashed. My grandkid has been telling nonsense about a giant monster. There are people fighting off some crazy biters. I hope they can hold off. Aha! Oh, wait. Another zombie spawned! Try not to hit the survivors. Okay. I suggest you not step on the puddle. Sometimes it electrocutes you. I found that out already. ooh. Oopsies, all puddles. Stop. Just, why am I having a hard time hitting you? What is that noise? That is the sweet sound of music. Nice. What is that's like an East Asian god.
Oh, that's creepy.
Why can't I hit him? My attacks do no damage.
Maybe they are doing damage.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
Oh, I've got 12 health left.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a health box. Cool. Destroy the fence! Yes, pull the trigger. I don't know what it does. Woo! That was great.
Nice.
I felt like something would crash, but I didn't expect that whole thing to move. Oh boy.
That was awesome.
Yeah, that worked out really well. Alright. Got an exit. Should I go back and talk to the other people? Like, hey, you can go now. Oh, I can check something. Undead giant, check. Whatever it is, it should rest now. Are you still alive? Are we in Atlanta?
I like that you couldn't attack him. We instantly look for plan B and yeah, I like that.
This is Atlanta. We are doomed. Bolt. Interesting. Well, that was a lot of fun. I liked that. Just don't jump on the side of the truck. And don't forget to check that house where Morgan is. I think a quest point for Morgan would be good. Like on the door, so you can like go back and check for it. Alright, I said I was going to show how big the dragons are. And then was I think we're done after that. What was that?
Was that 10 years after that game?
That one? No, that's Days Gone By? I think it was Days Gone By, right? It was like 120 something or other. Because 10 years after was the like the military one in the forest. And this was clearly supposed to be like right as soon as the apocalypse starts.
Yeah, Days Gone By, 183. It's on. By Dez.
Yep, there it is.
Awesome. Anyone else wants to play it?
Are there going to be any mounts in the sandbox? Possibly. There's still stuff we have to work out for that. We would like there to be. Ultimately, the sandbox is going to have visual scripting, so you're going to be able to program whatever you want. For now, we're focusing on making easy behaviors that pretty much anybody can pick up and just like read what they do and put together a game. But with visual scripting, the possibilities are going to be basically endless for what you could implement in your game. Are some of these games available for us? Yes, all 3,200 approximately games are available for you to play right now. So, yeah, there's 9 games on a page here and 346 pages, and you can go and play all of these right now. There are some, especially towards the back, the last like 50 pages or so, that are going to be possibly outdated. They might use mechanics that are no longer available in the Game Maker, so they might actually not be playable. But pretty much everything for the first 200, 300 pages should be playable. I would focus on ones that say The Walking Dead Game Jam right now, because a lot of new fresh content. I mean, like, all these screenshots, these look great. Like, so much work.
There's so many good entries.
Ravenwood, was that the one that we played, Joseph and I? I think so. This looks like that.
Yeah.
Setup. Just like all these screenshots look great. I want to play all of these like right now. Some of them.
It'll take you at least 2 weeks.
What was that?
It'll take you at least 2 weeks.
To play everything, yeah. Andy knows better than anybody else because Andy's one is the leader for the game jam and is one of the main judges. So he's been playing lots and lots and lots of The Walking Dead game jam games. All right, so we were going to look at what the rewards are. So it's the dragon, the alpha dragon. I think it's already minted. Let's see if we go to the market. We go to alpha dragon. Yep, here it is.
I'm excited to see this one. I've not seen it yet.
Now, I don't have this yet because I can't claim the rewards yet, so it's not in my inventory. But you can see it nice and big here. And it's 5.25 meters by 5 1/8 meter by 7 1/4 meters. I think the Z there is probably the length, tail to head, which would make Y the height,
so cool.
And X the width. Now it's gonna vary on those numbers. If you're flying, you know, you got a wider wingspan, things like that. These numbers, I think they only show up for admins right now. I did request that they be available to everybody to see. there's no real reason to not have that visible for everybody. But it's just sort of a tool that we use as we're reviewing people's work. And then if you want to see the Bone Dragon, I don't think there's any available for sale right now for less than like 15 ETH. Because there's only 5 minted. This is one of the original dragons that was ever made. This predates the dragon template. And this was made by Pepe, who is one of the artists in our creator fund, but he made this as part of the Vox Edit contest, the very first Vox Edit contest. So it's pretty cool. He also made, what do you mean the experience is still loading? Okay, I broke it again. All right, I think that means it's time for the stream to be done. My computer just hates me right now for some reason. All right, well, any WYSIHAT giveaways today? We already gave one away like an hour and a half ago. All right, thank you, Touche. Thank you, Andy. Be sure to check us out again on Monday as we play the new thing that's releasing on Monday. What is that? I don't remember.
I know what it is, and I forgot. It's a real good one. Tropical Park.
Oh yeah, oh, Tropical Park, nice. Is a parkour course with lots of fun hidden challenges. That one, I believe, you can access from the main hub. I think there's a portal for it, but if not, you can click on it, click play once you're in the alpha. It releases December 13th, which is Monday at 8. I guess it's 8 a.m. my time. I don't think that's
one,
UTC.
One UTC.
Yeah, it's,
one,
yeah, it's
UTC.
5 a.m. for me.
Okay. All right. So, yeah. 1 a.m. UTC, December 13th. and we will be playing this live on stream. So Andy, you play the games as they come out, right?
Yeah, so the marketing team asked if I'd cover them. So I'll go live on the Sandbox channel across everything through Restream.
So Andy will be live at 1 a.m. UTC on Monday. I'll be live 2 a.m. UTC on Tuesday playing the same thing. just because of the way that time zones work out. Lots of fun. All right. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Andy. Thank you, Touche. Everybody have a great weekend. We will see you again on Monday.
Take care, everyone.
See you guys.